The 2.0 version of PCSX2, the best PS2 emulator for a PC, has finally been released. A lot of the changes and improvements here on 2.0 have been around since the nightly build of PCSX2, and several improvements for graphics and performance across the whole emulator. In this video, I'll show you the full setup for PCSX2 on your PC with the best settings so you can play your favorite PS2 games on PC. Let's get going! The first step is downloading the emulator itself, and it's available here on their website. I'll put the link of this on the description of the video, and right here on the main page, you want to click here on Latest Stable, and it's going to list all the systems that this emulator is available for. This tutorial is for Windows 10 and 11, so I'm gonna click here on the first option, Installer. There's also the portable version available here, but we're gonna get the installer one because it keeps all the required files and folders on the same place. Go ahead and click on this one. It's gonna come as a single .ex file like this one, so go ahead and double click on it. And very likely you're gonna get this message from Windows saying that this file is apparently a virus, but this is just because this is a new file and it hasn't been checked by them yet, but it's safe. So go ahead and click here on More Info and then click on Run Anyway, and then it will take us to the installation process. On the first screen, you want to go ahead and select the portable installation right here. The only difference from this one is that all the files are going to be kept on the same folder, so it's much better for organizing everything. Now click on Next, and now you have to select the folder where you want the emulator to be installed. And ideally, you should keep the installation folder on the one that it tells you, because this emulator can have some problems if you install it on external drives or something like that. So it's best that you keep it here on the C drive. That's what I'm gonna do here, so go ahead and click on Next. Now this is the option if you want to create a start menu shortcut for this one as well. I'm just gonna go ahead and click on Next right here. Now it's gonna ask you if you want to create a desktop shortcut. I'm gonna go ahead and checkmark this one. Now you can review your settings. When you're done, go ahead and click on Install. This should only take a few seconds here. Then finally, we can launch PCSX2. So make sure this one is checked here and click on Finish. And we now have arrived at the setup wizard window. Some options here to select the language and the theme for this emulator. And this emulator is available on multiple languages right here. So just select the one you want to play as. I'm just gonna select the default one that is English. And you can also change the theme as well. I'm gonna keep mine on Dark Fusion Gray. But if you click on them, you can see how they look like right here. You have a bunch to select to. But in my case, I'm just gonna keep it this one here. You can also make the emulator check for updates every time you start it. That's up to you. I would recommend leaving this on actually so you can get the latest fixes and enhancements. Now go ahead and click on Next. Now here you have to select the folder where you want the emulator to scan for the BIOS files. And because I selected the default installation, they are located right here on the C drive. There is a PCSX2 folder and then the BIOS folder. I already navigated here to my computer where this is located, right? Once again, PC, local disk C, or PCSX2. So this is going to depend on where you choose to install everything right here. So inside the PCSX2 folder, there is the BIOS folder inside, and this is where you're going to be placing the BIOS file. And the BIOS files are protected by copyright, so ideally you should get them by dumping your BIOS from your PS2 into your PC, or you can try to find them on the internet. But this is something that I can't show you here on the video because it is against YouTube's guideline. If I share a link for BIOS download or just show in the video how you can get them on the internet, YouTube will delete my video. So when you finally have them with you, you're just gonna drop the file here on this folder. It's going to look something very similar to this one, a .bin file, but it can also come as a different file type here. So you're gonna drop it on this folder. Now you're gonna go back to the installation setup here, and you're gonna click on Refresh List. Then if you did it right, the BIOS file will be located right here. Now you just have to click on the BIOS file once to highlight it. Now go ahead and click on Next. This time you're gonna select the folder where you want the emulator to scan for games. For this one, what I like to do here is to go back to the PCSX2 folder, and I like creating a new folder here by clicking on the folder with the right button. Then you click on New and then Folder. And I simply just create a new folder here called Games, like this. Now you're gonna go back to the emulator. Then you're gonna click here on Add. It should open the previous folder where you're at. In my case, it was the BIOS folder, right? So now I'm just gonna navigate to the emulator folder. And then I'm just gonna click on the games folder once and then click on select folder. Then it will ask you if you want the emulator to scan for this folder every time you open it. Go ahead and click on yes. So every time you put a new game in here, the emulator will recognize it as soon as you start it. You can also select multiple folders here. It doesn't have to be just a single one. And you can just click here on add and keep adding more folders here where the game files are gonna be. Then when you're done, click on next. And now we have to configure the controller. This emulator has an automatic mapping function. So if you already have the device you want to use, plug it on your computer. You're gonna make sure that you have DualShock 2 selected here, and then you're gonna click on automatic mapping, and it's going to list all the available devices to be used as a controller. In my case, I have a Xbox controller, so I'm gonna click here on SDL0, and just like that, it's ready. And this emulator supports all the DualShock controllers and Xbox controllers as well, and even third-party controllers if you can make them being recognized as Xbox controllers. And you can use your keyboard as well if that's what you want to do. Later on, I'm going to show you how to further configure your controllers. But for now on, if you want to also use the port 2 controller, if you want to play games locally, do the exact same thing here for controller port 2. Now, go ahead and click here on next, and we're done with the setup installation. Now click here on finish, and it's going to take us to the emulator itself, which is going to look it's something like this. This is blank because I haven't added any games on the folder, right? And if you followed exactly what I did here, and you also have the games folder with you, this is where you're gonna be dropping your game files. One of the best and most common format for PCSX2 is having the games as a .iso format like this. And just like the BIOS, I can't show you here on the video where to get them, and also ideally, you should get them by dumping your copies of your game into your PC. And having them as a single .iso is enough here for this emulator. So now you're gonna go back to PCSX2, and you're just gonna click here on scan for new games, and just like that, the games in there are gonna show up in here. Now we're gonna configure the emulator settings for the best graphics and performance. I'm gonna start with the general settings of this emulator, and then we're gonna do the game specific settings. So start by clicking here on settings, and then click on the first option available, interface. On this first tab, there's some options here, but they don't affect the performance or the quality of the emulator. Stuff like starting the emulator at full screen, if you wanna do that. Also hide the cursor in full screen as well. Actually, this one is pretty good. I'm gonna use that. So configure this one in the way you want it. So now we're gonna head over here to the BIOS tab. In here, we have the option to enable fast boot on the emulator, and this will skip the PS2 startup screen whenever you start a game. So this is useful if you just want to get to your games fast. And there is also a fast forward boot as well, so you can start the game even faster. But these options can break some games, so I would not recommend using this one. Only the fast boot, really, if you want to skip the startup screen. Now we're gonna head over to the emulation tab. And right here, the only options that you want to make sure you have enabled is enable multi-thread VU1 and enable instant VU1. The rest, you don't have to change it. In fact, it's best that you don't, because this will affect the gameplay speed, and you should only use this if you really know what you're doing. The next option is the graphics tab, and this is where the fun is gonna start. Right here on top, where it says render it, there's a few graphical outputs we can select. And Vulkan is the one that performs the best for most games out there on this emulator. But if your GPU is outdated, it's not going to show up in here. If that's the case, the second best, in my opinion, is OpenGL, but Direct3D 11 and 12 are also pretty good in here. So if you're not sure what to choose from, you can go ahead and leave it on automatic. But if you have Vulkan, I would definitely recommend trying with these one on. But if you don't like it, choose either OpenGL or Direct3D. I'm gonna leave Vulkan selected here for my. And here on adapter, you wanna choose the graphics card that you want the emulator to use. If you have a multiple GPU setup, that is. In my case, I only have the GeForce RTX 37, so that's what I'm gonna select it here. Now, on display, there's only borders full screen to select here on full screen mode, and here on aspect ratio, this is the option that you wanna use if you want to stretch the image of your game. Some games on the PS2 are only available on the 4:3 aspect ratio, but some of them also have an option for widescreen 16:9. If you select widescreen and the game does not have support for that, the emulator will stretch the screen of the game to fit your monitor. But there's something very nice about PCSX2, which are the cheats. And a lot of games have support for widescreen patch on this emulator, so I'm gonna cover this on later on the video, but if you don't know which one to select for now, keep it on auto standard here. The next three options, the FMV aspect ratio, the interlacing, and bilinear filtering, you don't have to change this one. They're good to go on the default option here. Now let's head over to the rendering tab. And the first option here, internal resolution, is one feature that can make games look much better here on the emulator. You can either play your games on their native PS2 resolution here, or you can change all the way to 5K resolution. And ideally here, you want to select the resolution option that matches the resolution of your monitor. In my case, I have a 1080p monitor, so ideally, I want to leave it here on 3x native. But if you have a powerful PC and you want to go beyond that, you can select a resolution that is higher than your monitor. The emulator will render the game at that resolution, but it's going to be fit to be displayed on the resolution of your monitor. For the remaining options, the only one that I'm also gonna change here is anisotropic filtering. This one will make your games look much better and it has minimal impact on your GPU. So you can go ahead and select 16x with no trouble. The remaining options, ideally you wanna leave them on the default here unless the emulator tells you. That's because when you start the game, the emulator will tell you what are the best settings that you should use on rendering in order to get the best emulation out of the game. But be aware that these options can affect the performance on the emulator, especially on the CPU. This option here, blending accuracy, is one that's particularly heavy on the CPU. So use this one depending on the specs that you have and what the emulator tells you. On the texture replacement tab, these are the options that you want to change here if you're going to install one of those HD texture packs for your game. This emulator supports that and you can find these texture packs out on the internet and also if you just want to mod your game. Next, you're going to head over to the post-processing tab and you have some options here like sharpening with FXAA and it usually looks pretty good on the emulator. There's also features here too. Like for example, the Lotus CRT. This one is useful if you want to play your games like if you were playing on an actual old television, like if you were playing on an actual CRT monitor. So if you want a look that tries to be faithful to an actual PS2, this is the option here. There's also some other stuff if you want to mess with them and have fun, this is up to you. Next, we just have the OSD and recording tabs. And this is just stuff if you want to show the FPS on your game. If you want to get rid of the notifications, it shows up on the top left corner of the screen as well. And also for recording too, if you want to do actual gameplay recordings without using an external software. We now only have the audio tab here that you should leave it as default unless you know what you're doing here. Also the memory cards tab here if you want to format or use a different memory card or use a memory card that you got from the internet that has a specific save file from the game you're playing, you can do that here as well. And also the network configuration. This emulator can play games online and I actually have a video here on the channel showing you how to play online on PCSX2. I'll put the link of that one on the description of this video as well. And that's pretty much here for the standard settings of PCSX2. Now, for the game-specific settings, with your games loaded in here, in my case, I'm gonna use black as an example. You're gonna click on your game with the right button, and then you're gonna click here on Properties. And it's going to open a window that's very similar to the one that we were messing with just now. But we now have the Patches and the Cheats tab available. And to patch your game, you simply have to click here on patches, and the emulator will find the patches available to your game. And to activate them into your game, you just have to click here on enable, and the next time you start, it's going to enable those cheats. Be aware that some of them will have additional settings that you have to change in order for them to work properly, like the 60 FPS code for black, for example. You also have to enable the overclock under the emulation tab here in order to make sure that this one works properly. And there's the widescreen patch that I talked about before. Most games will have this one here, and if you're going to use that, make sure that you go to the graphics tab here and then change the aspect ratio to widescreen 16:9. Not every game will have their patches available here because they actually have to import those into the emulator database. So there's some that might be missing. And if that's the case, you have to manually add them yourself. And I happen to have a video here on the channel that covers that as well. So I'm gonna leave the link on the description of this video as well. Now, the next thing that I want to show you here is the option to add cover arts into your games. Right here on the options, you're gonna click here on this icon that has these four square right here, and it's going to switch to the cover art display. There's nothing selected here, and there is a fast way that you can get high quality cover arts to all the games that you currently have on the emulator. First, you're gonna click here on Tools, and then you're gonna select Cover Downloader. Now, on this window, we just have to input the URL to download covers from. And there is one that was made just for PCSX2. And it can be found on this post right here on GitHub. It's simply called PS2 Covers. I'll put the link on the description of the video as well. And they have a software that works really well, but it's much better for us to just grab the URL and just paste that on the emulator. And they give us an option here to download covers on the default format and also 3D covers. In my case, I'm gonna go with the 3D covers here. So you're gonna copy the URL here provided, or you can just click here, just copy that for you. And now go back to the emulator and you just have to paste the link right here and then click on start. And in just a matter of seconds, depending on how many games you have here, it's going to download the 3D cover arts for you or the standard format if you selected that. If you want to change from the 3D format to the standard one or the other way around, you have to delete the covers first, and you can find them here on the emulator folder, right here on the covers folder. Then you just have to delete those from here. And you just have to repeat the process again, selecting the tools here and then cover downloader. But this time you're gonna paste the link of the standard cover folder or the 3D one, depending on what you had before. Finally, when you're ready to play your games, you just have to simply double click them here on the emulator and they will start as such. I have many other tutorial videos like this on the channel, and if you want to directly support me with a donation, the link will be on the description of this video. Make sure to subscribe to the channel and also leave a like on this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon.